is a blue, shoots up through the stony ground. There's no room, no space to rent in this town. You're out of luck. And the reason that you had to care.
Okay.
Welcome to Kimberley! Kimberley, welcome to you, Joe.
Alright. Well, I'm happy to be here.
Yeah.
I hope Kimberley's a good sort, and she puts out.
Yeah, she's good.
Yeah, you'll find a couple of cougars.
Oh yeah.
Cougar.
Okay, so are we going for a wander in the bushes?
Yeah, let's go.
This is Mr. Scott Adams, typical Canadian.
How's it going, mate?
That doesn't sound real Canadian to me. But you do live in Canada. Oh yes. And check out Scott's neighbourhood. You see up in the mountains there. Lots of ski slopes. Lots of snow. And he's a typical lumberjack. He's good looking, isn't he?
Yeah. I hope he puts it in.
This place here, Kimberley, BC, and British Columbia. And we have our resident tour guide, Mr. Scott Adams, a typical Canadian dude.
How's it going, eh?
So, can you tell me a little bit of history about this area since you've lived here all your life?
All my life?
Yeah.
No, you're wrong, mate.
Right. What's that accent you're putting on? Come on, speaking Canadian.
I am.
Come on, you're a liar. Now tell me some history.
History about this clock? I can actually tell you some history about this clock.
Yeah?
This clock was built by one man that I know of, which was, his name was Dick Bover. And a bunch of his friends got together and built this clock.
Yeah?
And they decided that they wanted to put in the Plattsville here. But the city council wouldn't allow it. So what they did was they made the clock and they transferred the clock into the Plattsville late at night and left it there.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
And then the next morning,
yeah,
people were like, where the hell did this clock come from?
Okay.
And that's the story.
World's largest cuckoo clock.
There you go.
From a typical Canadian dude. He's lived in Canada all his life.
How's it going?
This is the back door. And, ooh, who's that? Scott, oh yeah. Apparently he always thinks of Chris. He thinks of the back door.
I miss your back door.
Market. And it's apparently a very special place. And why is this so, young Scott?
This is the meeting place where I met my wife.
Oh.
Sherry Shreves, parkmate Adams.
Okay. Alright, so what are the chances of me meeting a hot shitty babe in Kimberley?
You never know, you're liking the big city.
Alright, well let's check out the point of first contact. Alright, as we walk over into the vegetable section. So this is the pickup joint, is it?
This is it, mate. Sweet potatoes.
Yeah?
This is where I met Sherry.
And she thought you were quite sweet, like a potato?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. I was in here picking up some groceries one day.
Go online, what'd you say?
I was up this end of the grocery store.
Right over here, yeah.
And a friend of mine, Will, had met Sherry the year before.
Yeah.
He saw her, and he went out to her and started talking to her.
So you may hit on her first.
Mate?
You may hit on her first.
No, he was general just friends with her the year before. And then they ran into each other, and hey, how's it going? And then I was up here.
Hey, how's it going? Oh, okay.
There's a bear in there. And a chair as well.
Well, what about this Mozart Inn. The ice cream dude.
That's a pretty good restaurant. Good food in there.
Oh, it's closed.
Yeah, it's closed. They open until 5 o'clock.
Yeah. But what's so good about this place? What's happened here?
Not much. You know, been out for dinner there a couple of times.
It was your first day, come on!
No, not there!
Well, where was it?
Here!
Oh, there you go, sorry!
Snowdrift.
Snowdrift Cafe, yeah, right.
Yeah. See that lady sitting with a red jacket on?
Oh, yeah.
That's the table.
Alright. Cool. You guys see these in the reflection.
Okay. Alright, here we have Scott driving in Canada, in the Rocky Mountains. Golf course. You'd struggle to find your ball, wouldn't you? In the snow.
Yeah, it's pretty tough.
Alright, take two. Now, where are we on the spot?
We are at one of the highest points you can get to by car, up by the ski hill. The mountain range out here is the Purcell Mountain Range, Rocky Mountains. It's not the best view today, a little clouded in. But hopefully while Joey's here we can get a nice sunny day. Give you a better perspective of what's around us. There you see that run there where the chairlift is.
Yeah.
That's called the main run of the hill. You can't see very much of the hill from here.
And this is where Scott used to train in his Olympian days.
Yep. If you can see through the trees there, there's blue fence.
Yeah.
It goes up and up and up. It goes up the fairway. That's the training run we used to use. Four disciplines.
Four disciplines?
Yeah, downhill. Super key. Try it slower and slower. Oh. This is what I competed in.
Alright. Yeah. Oh, thank you, Scott, for taking us on this journey. Mr. and Mrs. Adams. Walking their puppies. Alright, so what's going on here, Scott? Hey, picking up some dog biscuits. Very good. What fun. Do you eat it? Do you use it as fertilizer in your garden or anything like that? Oh, hello. You're just hanging out, through you. Just hanging out, eh?
Hello, my dear. What do you call a deer with no eyes? No idea.
What do you call a deer with no eyes and no legs?
No idea.
Still no idea.
What do you call a deer with no eyes, no legs, and no dick?
Still no fucking idea.
In trouble? In trouble, deer?
Oh, is that you, deer?
No,
that was you, my deer. That was you, wasn't it? Yeah. Oh yeah.
They really like it.
They do. Hey. It's got a very Canadian of you to have flags in your yard.
Sherry put those up for the Olympics and Paralympics. I put my Australian flag up inside.
Alright. And Sherry, what's going on there? What are you doing?
Yeah, I'm making dessert.
Ah, for tonight. Good stuff.
I'm collecting the local fruit.
Local berries.
The dogs help you out there apparently.
Yeah. Recycle. It's called
poopsicles. Oh, the poopsicles. It's a famous Canadian dessert, isn't it?
Yeah. Can't wait to try it.
What's going on here?
Cutting on mushrooms, mate.
Yeah. That's good. Down in the Adams house.
Chili, mate. Turkey, chili.
Well, you know, and it's weather like this.
Yeah.
Gotta eat something hot.
Yeah. Spice it up.
Yeah.
Yeah. My wife wouldn't just buy things I wouldn't want.
Mr. Noopsy, where are we today? Where are we going?
We're at Elizabeth Lake.
Elizabeth Lake, yeah, over here, okay. Oh, look, there's a wolf, a wolverine.
A wolverine dog.
Right there.
Fluffy tail.
Right.
Do you want to get the mic on?
And it's just started to
snow. Lots of snow.
Today we're at Elizabeth Lake. A lovely frozen lake just outside of Cranbrook. And you can see it's fucking cold.
Yes.
And windy. And there's a there geese walking out of the lake.
Oh yes, there is.
There you go.
Let's zoom in on him. Well, if he can do it, I think you can do it, Scott.
Yeah, I'm gonna give
go
it a go.
Go on, give it a shot. Let's walk on water. Now.
It's hard. Look at that.
You can walk on that.
Jump in.
You can walk on that, come on. Man, we got to get onto that white bit, because I reckon that'd be hard enough to walk on. So, swim out there. Go on.
That'd be a pussy all your life.
You're a nut.
This raging river.
This is fucking sketchy.
Come on, you can do this. Oh, look, he's going to use some sticks. My sticks, actually. Oh, it's sinking.
Holy fucking
shit.
Is he
going to make it? Don't fall in, Mr. Nopsy. You can do it!
Oh, he does it with ease.
Yeah! That's rock and roll! Yeah!
Jeez, look at it. I don't think it tastes any good.
What kind of birds do we have here, young Scott? These the blue jays? They're a nice young blue jay. He's nice and blue. I need a tripod though so I can hold this fuck still. Oh yeah.
Just come out of the jungle. Got some photos.
Let's take photos off.
Just coming back to report. I got a photo of a duck.
Yeah.
Not a geese, a duck.
Duck.
There.
Okay. So, Mr. Scott. What can you tell us about this area? What can you tell us about this area?
What plants?
Yeah? What's that noise?
That park guide came out and said, can you please water the plants when you're going around?
Okay. Oh. So you're creating a bit of yellow snow?
Yeah.
Alright.
Well. I'm just adding to the Elizabeth Lake.
Alright, well, remember anything more than 3 shakes is a pull. Alright, Scott, let's go. He's gonna skim some rocks on this lake. Lake Elizabeth, and let's see how well you go. Yeah. It's not a really good skimming rock, that one, but well, we'll see how it goes. That's no way that's gonna skim. Oh, hang on. How are you? That was awesome. So, tell me a little about this statue, or whatever that, or whatever you call it, rock formation.
Or the Nookshuk.
Yes, what is it? What's the go?
It's an indigenous landmark to say that humans have been here.
Okay, and they started way back in the days of the Indians.
Yep.
The Aboriginals, whatever you call them. What do you call them? Indigenous, Aboriginal, or what?
I think it's the Inuit.
Inuit.
I believe it's the Inuit.
Okay.
They still use them, I think, don't
they? Well, no, everybody does.
Yeah,
you're
like
on a trail.
What gang are you doing? What are you doing? Get in the hole. Yeah, get in the hole.
Yeah.
Get in the hole. Well, most dogs love water, but this is a different kind of water.
There he is on his back.
There you go, drag him.
I've never seen a diamond in the flesh. I cut my teeth on wedding rings.
You make snow angels.
I've never made snow angels in my life before.
Yeah, that one.
Lesson in snow angels. Imagine if it was lesson in skiing.
If it was what?
Lesson in skiing.
Skiing?
As if this is...
Ready?
Oh! I can't do it, it's too chunky.
We can do it, we can do it. We are, I don't know, are we snow angels or snow devils?
Snow devils.
We have some yellow snow. I'm aiming at the yellow bits.
This is going to be the best part, is getting up.
Sorry.
As we zoom in on the angels, who's got the better one? You think Sherry or the judge?
Okay. oh my goodness.
It's a tough call, isn't it?
It's a tough call. yours looks more like an angel, but Scott's has more depth.
All right, here we have Mr. Numpsy, the Canadian chef extraordinaire. And as you can see, we have the Canadian flags in the background.
They are.
Okay. And we're cooking, we're having a typical Canadian dish. What do you call this? The lumberjack barbecue. And if we look out here,
where the fuck is the light?
You can see. Oh, look up there, it's a little bit of pinky action. I like the pink bits. And ski fields over there, and then we have the face on the tree, the mysterious face in the tree. He's always looking at us.
What are you drinking there? That's garlic bread.
What's that?
I'm drinking called Innocent Gun.
Innocent Gun, wow.
Scottish beer.
The action shot. Here we have a few Santas. Santas for sale, 3 for $25. And they were made by this young man. He's quite clever, isn't he?
Where are we off to today? So we're going for about, probably, say, about an hour or so from Kimberley. Drive, we're gonna go up to...
Look at this view, not bad. The trees are in the way, but...
Your darkest moments I can see now. I can see no end, and all of the ghouls come out to play.
Did you bring your crampons?
Did I bring my tampons? No, I forgot to bring my tampons.
Oh, yeah.
What do we need tampons?
Shit out of one.
Okay. But yes, check this out. Over there as well.
I'm in Mulberry Lake in the middle of the Rockies with this amazing view. And today I'm gonna try and do what no man has done before. Not even Jesus. I'm gonna walk on water on this lake.
Yeah, just gonna test it out first. Yeah.
Just test it once again. Yeah, that's strong, that's strong
Mr. Noopsy, we've been walking along this track for a while, and we've come across some what?
Some
cougar.
Cougar tracks.
Cougar. Oh, well, I like the odd cougar. I'm actually dating a cougar. She's a bit older than me, so she's a cougar. But cougar was obviously a bit thirsty. It's gone down there.
Could be a dog.
Who knows? But, well, let's continue the journey into the woods. Find a bear or two. There's a bear in there. And a cougar as well. There's a wolverine. And a noxie. Oh, fresh cougar tracks. Yes. And this is what cougars hunt for. For young men like him. Young vulnerable men like him. Look at him. Here. Oh dear. Oh dear, there's a deer.
What are you doing? Watering the guards.
Are you taking a piss?
Fucking hell.
That'd be right. But there's a shelter food source. There's a loony. Apparently there's a few out there in the water.
Help!
I'm the video man, I'm not the action man. You're Bear, the Bear Grylls of Canada. Jump, jump. Crash, crash, you'll make it. Jump, jump. I've only just seen. Well, Mr. Noomsy, we've come across a wolf. So, how are we gonna get past this wolf? He looks pretty hungry. Are we alright? Oh, he must be one of those snow wolves, because he's white. 100 metres from the car. Man. Made it all the way around the whole lake.
It turns out that I can't walk on water. It's fucking cold in here.
Joe is falling in.
I'm gonna love it. Love it. It's karma, bitch.
Oh, it's dead.
How you feeling?
My legs are cold. My hands are cold. I don't know how close to the edge I should be walking right now.
Yeah. Holy shit, man. Mr. Squirrel, make some noise again. Hey.
Oh, he took off.
He's
back.
Yeah, here we are walking again with the Adams family. We have Scott, Sherry, Gabby, and Kanga.
I just found a hand.
That one's Kanga. That one's Gabby.
I just found a hand.
A hand?
Yeah.
Well, that often happens around here. People losing to frostbite, losing hands, feet,
legs.
Legs? Yeah, there you go, for another frostbite victim.
So, up above here, in front of us, we have Happy Hands. He's Kimberley's mascot.
Hey, Happy Hands.
He's basically a drunk German in Lederhosen. And why he's Kimberley's mascot is years ago, there was a German got drunk and ended up on an international flight to Canada and got on a Greyhound and ended up in Kimberley, and they found him in the middle of the town square, passed out drunk. And they thought, hey, this is a great idea, let's make
Great Town mascot, yeah.
Yeah, it's all about the beer stein.
Hey, mate.
This is a job I'm doing at the moment for a customer. It's an old cabinet. It's about 100 years old, this one. What are you doing to it?
Refinishing it. Refinished.
Repaired this old chair for this one here.
Come on, you're good at that. Good at restoration, right?
I haven't finished yet, mate. Come on.
You just
smashing things.
Yeah.
And you people expect people to pay you for smashing things?
Yeah.
Really,
yeah. I refinished that table.
Which
one? This big one here. It used to be a dining room table.
Yeah,
I made it short. I made it a coffee table.
So there you go. That's Adam's furniture restoration.
I'm finished.
Call this number now.
This one here with a TV sitting on. I made that.
Alright.
And that one.
These
bees?
Yeah.
You look a little wobbly.
The doctors said that it's irreversible, this operation, so...
Well, what's that thing hanging out your bum?
What thing? Where?
Oh, yeah, feel what?
Hey, what are you doing? What are you doing? This is someone like...
Hey, what's going on?
Someone's trying to destroy your car.
How you doing?
Oh. Okay. Go for it.
We know the men sit cushy and warm inside. Yeah. I'm going to scrape the car.
I'm good. I'm warm. Yeah. Hurry up. Come on. We haven't got all day. Come on. We haven't got all day. Let's go.
Yeah, that's all right, brother. That's all right.
Oh, yeah. We have our... personal female slave.
Sink in the river, the lessons I've learned.